Hey guys, my name is Steph and I want to welcome you to my channel. If you love all things fashion, please make sure to hit that subscribe button down below for all upcoming videos. So there is two things I want to talk about right before getting into this video. The first thing is thank you guys so much for getting me to 100 subscribers. I know that 100 may not be such a big number compared to all the numbers that we're used to seeing on YouTube, but for me, that means the world. For me, 100 is kind of like saying 2 million. I'm so happy that you guys subscribe, that you guys comment below, that you guys enjoy my content. I love chatting with you guys, and I'm so grateful. If you know me, you know that I'm someone that's very, very shy, and even just getting in front of a camera and talking is like so hard for me, and I'm so proud of myself for being able to do this, and so happy that you guys are enjoying it and subscribing, so there will never be enough words to say how grateful I am. Thank you guys so much. The second thing I do want to say is my channel is mostly based on luxury fashion, materialistic things, and I know how people can be. No, I am not a materialist. Well, yeah, I do enjoy materialistic things, but my world doesn't revolve around material stuff. I mean, it is just material. I have more things that are important in my life, my family, the world, the way things are going. So I just want to use this platform to keep it very like light and my love for fashion, showing all the stuff that I've bought, things that are coming up. I would like to share a few vlogs here and there, keeping my baby out of the way because I know how cruel the internet can be. But this is just a place for light heart content, like fun, being a girl, enjoying fashion, and all that good jazz. So yeah, as mentioned before, I just wanna thank you guys for subscribing, and there are not enough words to say how thankful I am, and yeah, let's get right into it. Today's video is gonna be a little different. I'm giving myself a break from the hauls because my bank account asked me to. I thought I would do my 2020 wish list, which is really like 3 months of 2020 that's left. So yeah, I figured I would do that. These are items that I don't plan on purchasing anytime soon, but I really, really do want them, and Christmas is coming. So mom, husband, best friends, Mrs. Ramirez from Sweet 611. I'm just kidding. I did write the list down on my phone just because I did not want to forget. Let's kill this love. Yeah, I'm obsessed. For all the items that are on my wish list, I will be putting a picture somewhere on the screen, and I will be listing their estimated retail price if I can find it. Hopefully I can. The first item on my wish list is still very much the Hermes Mini Kelly and Epsom leather in either a baby pink or a baby blue. I just really, really, really still want that, even though like I did take a hit with that Birkin because it was a little pricey. It is something that is at the top of my wish list, and I will not stop until I get one. And while we're on the topic of Hermes, I definitely want to get the Avalon blanket for myself and two of the pillows in the dark gray. I used to have the Avalon blanket in a dark gray, and then I sold it because I felt like I wasn't really using it. It was more for decor. I really, really regret that. So here I am again wanting to get it. I possibly will buy that, hopefully sometime soon. So those three items are definitely at the top of my list. The Mini Kelly, the Avalon blanket, and the pillows. Definitely want those. Next thing on my list that I really, really want is the Chanel Classic Flap in the baby blue that's coming out for Cruise November 2020. I have seen so many people talk about this bag. I know that it's something that a lot of your favorite influencers and mine are gonna have, but that's definitely at the top of my list. I would love to get a classic flap in a fun color between a Barbie pink and definitely that baby blue. As you can see, there's a theme. I love pink, blue, lavender, all those cotton candy, sky, baby rainbow colors. Those are my favorites. So I definitely want to get my hands on a classic flap in a fun color. A lot of people go for black bags, which is completely fine because it makes them timeless, but I get bored of black really fast. Like, I know I got my Birkin in black, and I think that's a perfect bag to get in black. With the rose gold hardware, which gives it a special touch. As far as Chanel Classic Flaps, I would definitely want one in a fun color. That baby blue is at the very top of my list. Although the way those Chanel price increases are going, I'm not really sure I'm gonna get one anytime soon. The next thing that this is definitely on my Christmas wish list, Prada Lug Sole Combat Boot. I absolutely love it. I'm gonna post a picture of it, but like, as you can see, Look at that. She is precious. The only thing that makes me iffy about it is the fact that it's a boot and I do have thicker legs and I am short. So I just don't know if it'll look wonky on me, but that is definitely something I want and I will be putting on my Christmas list because I am obsessed. They make anything look cute. Jeans, shorts, skirt. Just imagine a cute shirt, a little school skirt, a skort possibly, yep, with tights and those boots on. Love, love, love. So they're definitely gonna go on my Christmas list, but I have to try them on. I have to go somewhere and try them on just to see what they look like on me because don't wanna look like a clown. We have my ultimate dream item. This is here just for fun because honestly, like, I'm not gonna fork out the money for this. It is the butterfly Rolex watch. It is absolutely stunning. I will put a picture here. It is a rose gold piece with a diamond out face and then butterflies carved into it with like mother of pearl, and it is absolutely stunning, absolutely expensive, but it's definitely one of those dream pieces that hopefully is around when I hit a very big milestone and I am able to purchase it for myself. As you guys know, or I don't know if you know, but I am someone who absolutely adores butterflies. My dad passed away 2 years ago, and a little bit after he passed, I always say the story, I had a dream where he told me that he was fine and that anytime I saw a butterfly to remember him, because that's him visiting me. So butterflies are extremely, extremely special to me, and I would love to be able to have it in a jewelry timepiece. I do have a lot of butterfly jewelry pieces, but a timepiece would just be so, so special. So hopefully this model still exists whenever I hit a milestone or win the lottery and I can buy it for myself. It would be so beautiful to be able to have it and then pass it down to my daughter and she passes it down and it goes on and on and on for generations. And that is a way that I hope, you know, my children and their children remember my dad and something that was really special to me. This next thing is something that I just told my husband I wanted and he completely rolled his eyes. I don't know if you guys have seen the Blackpink ice cream music video, Jisoo wearing the Dior hat with the veil. I absolutely love it. I want it so bad. I went and tried it on and I put it aside. I was gonna buy it that weekend, but then something happened and I didn't, and I still haven't gone back for it. And I was telling my husband that I really, really want this piece just because I envision it in my future closet with like the little mannequin head, whatever it is, just there. It'll look so beautiful. So that is something that I definitely think I'm gonna pick up hopefully by Christmas because I love that hat. I feel like Dior has a way of doing a lot of things that are very like fashion forward but still have a princessy touch to them, like the hat with a veil. Come on, that is absolutely stunning. Oh my god, I hate thinking about things that I want to get because then I like harp on them. I would love to add a Cartier Just Uniqlo bracelet, the very thin one with the diamonds all around the head of the nail. I don't really like the thick one too much. If you can see my arm candy, it's mostly, I do have the regular size love bracelet. Hopefully you can see it. But then a lot of the pieces that I do keep on me are on the dainty side, and I just feel like the Just Uniqlo, the thin one, would go perfect with my arm stack. Last week, I was minding my business, and then I came across, I'm gonna butcher her name probably, but I absolutely love her, Tamara Kalinic, Instagram, and she was at the Fendi event, and she was gifted this Fendi Nano Baguette in pink, absolutely stunning. Now, I was never into the whole baguette thing, like I think they're all beautiful, it's just something I never saw myself owning. The one thing that did make this piece special, I believe it's called Fendi Frenesia. I want it so bad. It's because it's a collaboration with one of my favorite perfumes, which is by Maison France. I'm looking down because I have his name right here, but I'm still gonna butcher it no matter what. Maison France's Kirkjian? Maison France's, you know, the one that makes the Baccarat perfumes, that guy. So this is a limited edition of the iconic baguette bag in its nano version. The bag is infused with this perfume that is exclusively made for Fendi, and I believe the scent sticks to the bag for 4 years. I have once again reached out to Gab Waller and her team to source this out for me because it's not in the United States, and this is a must have. One, it's pink, and two, it's my favorite fragrance house combining together, and the fact that the bag will smell like this for 4 years, I mean, how could you not? And it'll be cute to just like clip it onto any other bag that you have because it is like a charm. I will post a picture of it. But for me, it's mostly gonna be a collector's piece that's gonna remain in my purse closet. Now, the next product is very, you either love it or you hate it. I love it. I love that vintage look to it. It is the Prada re-edition handbag. And I'm not sure if I want to get it with just the handle or with the long strap that has the AirPod case. Not sure yet. But I do know that I want to get my hands on it. Gonna add it on my Christmas list. And I do want to get it in a really, really fun color. Definitely don't want black or nudes. I just feel like I really don't gravitate toward nude colored bags. I know it's weird because a lot of people prefer colors like black, nude, white. I feel like this bag would be so, so cute with a fun color. I don't want to say baby blue or pink. I feel like I've said that for all the bags that I want so far. Possibly a yellow. Man, if they did a lavender color, it would be absolutely stunning. I think I would gravitate more towards that because it is a small bag, so a pop of color looks fun. Next on my wish list is the Chanel AirPod case, the tweed one, the pink one with the two little clips. I know it's dumb. The case costs more than the actual AirPods themselves, but it's such a cute piece, and I just love little charms that you can possibly hang on your bag and store my AirPod in them. Duh. So while that is on my wish list, like, I'm not sure I'm really gonna go out and get it. The next thing on my list, I'm a little like, I kind of want it, and then I don't. Like, yesterday, I felt like I really, really want it. Today, I woke up, and I was like, nah, I'll be fine without it. I go on and off about it. I don't know. It would be the Bottega Veneta cassette flat bag. I just don't know if I love it enough to buy it, but I do love seeing it on other people. This bag, I would want it in either two colors. A white, just to go with the neutral. That baby blue tour, I'll post a picture of it here. It is absolutely stunning. I remember when the pouch came out in this color, in the intrecciato leather, I believe it's called intrecciato. I absolutely loved it so much, but by the time I decided I wanted to get the pouch, it was completely sold out. And the cassette bag came in this color. At the time, I wasn't fully convinced. I was like, I just don't know if I would like the style. I don't know if it's a piece that's gonna maintain its momentum or if it's just gonna be like one moment and then you're on to the next thing. But you know, now seeing it more and more, it feels like it's a style that's not going anywhere anytime soon. So yeah, like I said, there are days that I want it, days that I don't, but if I did decide to get it, it would be between those two colors. So much for me being like, I don't want that many things. The final thing on my wish list is something that I've wanted for years. I just feel like I don't really see a need for it, but now I'm just kind of like harping on the fact that I really, really want it. And it is the Chanel XXL classic flat bag in either black or a fun nylon color. I absolutely love this bag. I think it is perfect for a weekend in Orlando. You know, you just take all your goodies in there. I love seeing girls when they're traveling and they use that bag on top of their suitcases. Absolutely beautiful. I think it's more the visual for me, but it is a piece that I've wanted for so long. Luckily, love my job working with handbags, and we do see a lot of them come in. So that is definitely something that I am hoping to get sometime soon. That's it, you guys. That's pretty much my 2020 wish list. Dropping it right before the holiday. Gotta be smart. Please let me know what's on your wish list. And if you own any of the items that I've talked about, please let me know how you're liking them. Are they a great investment? What are your thoughts on it? Just comment below. I love chatting with you guys. Also, let me know what you guys would like to see next. And until then, bye. Well, whatever's left of 2020, which is like 4 months, 9, 10, 11, what? As far as Chanel, as far air and airplanes, I mean, I want an airplane for sure. The final thing on my wish list is something that I wanted for, hello? Yes? I'm sorry, who are you calling?
I was trying to get in touch with Desiree Presley. This is not Desiree?
No.
I'm sorry.
Okay. And until then, bye.